Welcome. My name is William Standard, and I will present here a virtual reality adaptation of a psychological stress test called the TRIA Social Stress Test from a collaboration between the HCR Department and the Department of Biological and Clinical Psychology of the University of Trier. The main motivation behind creating this tool is linked to stress. But what is stress? Stress is the body's reaction to any change that requires an adjustment or response. The body reacts to these changes with physical, mental, and emotional responses. You can experience stress from your environment, your body, and your thoughts. Even positive life changes, such as a promotion, a mortgage, or the birth of a child, produce stress. While stress itself is not necessarily a bad thing, chronic stress can lead to health issues. In 1999, the World Health Organization has estimated that over half the sick days in the EU are related to stress, resulting in a 20 billion euro cost. Ever since then, stress-related problems have only increased. To understand how stress affects us, psychologists created tasks that induce stress in order to monitor it in a controlled environment. Some examples of the developed tasks are the TRIA social stress test, which we will be focusing on here, the socially evaluated cold pressure test, and the MASTRS acute stress test. The TSST was the first test to reliably evoke stress responses and is to this day widely used in stress research. The main factors for inducing stress are social evaluative threat and lack of control, which have been found to be robust to protocol variations, meaning that design changes shouldn't affect the outcome as long as those two factors are still present. The TSST consists of an anticipation phase in which the participant is instructed to prepare for a job interview at a job of his choosing. After 5 minutes, the mock interview begins in front of an audience, which concludes in another 5 minutes when the participant has to perform some mental arithmetic, usually counting backwards in steps of 13 or 17 from a number such as 1,022. The mock interview and the arithmetic task is conducted in front of an audience consisting of two or three judges. The judges are trained to keep a neutral expression throughout the test. Usually there is one active judge who occasionally makes small comments from a fixed list if the participant stops talking for too long, for example, or makes a mistake during the arithmetic task. An example for a comment would be, "What are your strengths?" to nudge the participant to continue talking. The other judges are considered passive and only pretend to take notes on occasion. This test is quite suited to be adapted to virtual reality, as aside from the advantages that a lot of tests would gain by a VR implementation, such as standardization, less personnel needed, and changeable environments, the expressionless judges that rely only on a fixed list of comments are easily implemented in VR. There have been multiple different VR adaptations of the TSST already, which have been validated, but all suffer from the same problems, preventing a widely spread use of them. Firstly, so far there exists no freely accessible version, and purchasing a license to use one is quite costly. Even the newest validated VR TSST version is still outdated, as it runs only on specific hardware with an Oculus Rift DK2. It was created using the Source engine and requires someone well-versed in C++ to make any changes to it. Therefore, our goal was to create a VR version of the TSST that is freely accessible and for psychologists without coding capabilities to be able to make changes. Additionally, we make use of the recent advancements in VR technologies to create a smoother VR experience with improved graphics. In order to allow customization without being too complicated, we created a number of actions that can be called with different parameters, such as speaking with the path to an audio file. The experimenter can add these events to a JSON file, which can then be triggered remotely by pressing a button on a specifically created client. The client retrieves a list of possible actions from the VR application and displays them. Other actions, such as writing or changing positions, can be set to trigger randomly at specific frequencies. Custom audio files also can be used without the need to manually animate mouth movements, as we are using Oculus Lip Sync. Oculus Lip Sync can adjust mouth movements in real time. For this, it uses 15 visimes, which are mouth blend shapes that are mapped to specific sounds, such as A, Ch, or E. which also means that our VR TSST version can easily be adapted to any language. We can see here a small cutout from a JSON file showcasing two actions. The first action prompts the judge named Agent 1 to speak, with a path to the audio file it should play back. The second action tells Agent 1 to turn on the camera, a specific animation where the judge presses a button, after which a light on the camera turns on. We will first look at a sample clip to get a better impression of the current state.
Warum halten Sie sich für geeigneter als andere Bewerber?
Here the participant would be talking and answering the question, which we haven't recorded here.
Welche Schwächen haben Sie?
There are a few things happening in this clip. Firstly, the agent seated in the middle speaks, which is an action that the experimenter had to specifically execute. Then we see the left agent right on the clipboard, which is a random event that triggered, as are the middle agent leaning back and the glancing at the clipboards. Lastly, the middle agent speaks again, which is once more executed by the experimenter. The tool has yet to be validated, as the current situation makes it slightly more complicated. However, we do hope to get started in November. Also, due to most psychologists being unfamiliar with JSON files, we plan on creating an event configurator, a simple graphical user interface that lets the user add and change previous mentioned events. Instead of being stuck with the current existing agents, we plan on implementing more models, which the experimenter can choose from. Additionally, by implementing more features such as eye tracking, researchers might use additional biometers for stress research. There are, of course, limits to what can be changed without changing the source project, the biggest restriction being changing models and animations, as those require manual editing before being usable. Also, adding new actions that aren't already built in, like rotating the camera for whatever reason one might want to do that, isn't possible without editing source code. Same for changing the lighting, surroundings, and environment. Unfortunately, we are slightly limited in openly distributing the source project, as the models for the agents we use require licenses. Therefore, we cannot include those in an openly accessible source project. The models were created using Adobe Fuse CC and then rigged using Mixamo. Both require free licenses, which means we cannot distribute them openly. However, anyone can acquire the licenses for free, after which we can then provide the models. That being said, of course, the compiled project has all the models included and it can be used without additional steps. The project will be published on GitHub after it has been validated. A link and the QR code to the future project is displayed on the right side. Thank you for watching.